by acknowledging the land and our responsibility to care for and respect all that creation gives to provide us with life. This land upon which we live, work, and sustain ourselves is the ancestral and treaty lands of the Mississaugas and Anishinaabeg, also known today as the Mississaugas of the Credit, the rightful caretakers and title holders of this land. We also recognize that this land is rich in pre-contact history and relationships, which includes the Anishinaabeg and Ongahungwe, and since European contact has and continues to become home for Indigenous and non-Indigenous peoples. As a responsible community, we believe all people are sacred and possess inherent and immeasurable worth and dignity. Colonialism displaced and dispossessed Indigenous peoples of their ancestral lands and continues to deny their basic human rights, dignities, and freedoms. We are committed to the sacrament of reconciliation, making reparations and fulfilling our treaty obligations, duties, and responsibilities as outlined in the Godot Nagana Dish with One Spoon Wampum. This treaty governs and affirms that we actively maintain mutually beneficial relationships and collectively respect and care for the land, water, animals, and each other in order to guarantee a good life for our future descendants.
Good morning, CA, and welcome to Wellness Wednesday, Episode 5, brought to you by your Brave team. Today's topic is how to support positive mental health right now, by Neha, Kyla, and Raman. Firstly, do some good. Scientific evidence shows that compassion can calm our minds. Consider who in your life might be a part of a vulnerable population and find a way to help them out, always practicing COVID protocols. Look out for the people you love. COVID-19 has been dominating our conversations. When you're checking in with your friends and family, try to ask about other things that are going on in their lives too. Head to bethere.org to learn how to support someone who may be struggling. Adapt your self-care routine. Some of your self-care strategies might be disrupted for a while. For example, your gym or your favorite restaurant may close. Consider what you can do differently and take this as a chance to try something new. Stay connected. Check in with the people you love and come up with a plan to stay close and engaged with one another. We have so many digital options. Use them. Embrace the good. Take heart in knowing that health officials, governments, and institutions are working proactively to slow the spread of COVID-19 and minimize the harm it will do. Plus, people everywhere are rallying to help each other out. And remember that it is okay to tune out. The 24-hour news cycle, it's a lot at the best of times. Feel free to take a break from the updates if they're negatively impacting your mental health. How can you deal with emotional exhaustion? Emotional exhaustion is a state of feeling emotionally worn out and drained as a result of accumulated stress from your personal or work lives, or a combination of both. People experiencing emotional exhaustion often feel like they have no power or control over what happens in life. They may feel stuck or trapped in a situation. So how do we tackle emotional exhaustion? Here are some tips. eliminate the stressors, eat healthy, exercise, get enough sleep, practice mindfulness, connect with a trusted friend, and take a break. And don't forget to play. Use the extra time to cook up a storm, play a long-forgotten board game, or dance like nobody's watching. It's also important to remember to practice media literacy. Stick to reliable sources of information like Public Health Canada and the World Health Organization for your updates. Avoid speculation and make sure you don't spread misinformation. Please take time to take care of yourself and practice self-care. Do some things that you enjoy. Some ideas are learn to play a new song. Give yourself a mani or pedi. Read, dance, paint, draw, sketch, bake, exercise, have your own spa day, journal, spend some time in the sun, go for a bike ride, or even a walk. Here are some tips for good mental health and self-care. It is quite a bit of information, so this presentation is saved on Mr. Minardi's YouTube channel. But the highlights are to take a break from social media, practice relaxation techniques, talk about your feelings, and accept who you are. These are some useful websites that were used to create this presentation. Thank you for watching this presentation brought to you by Brave. And remember, it will be posted in case you want to take a closer look at it. Take care.
Good morning, Amrbozic, and thank you, Brave, for that beautiful presentation. And with that in mind, let us pray. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord God, we recognize that sometimes you speak louder in the silence. Help us to be okay with the silence and learn to listen to your voice. Lord God, during times of struggle, help guide us to speak to those that can help us and understand our own limitations. We're going to take a moment of silence just to think of something that you are worried about and ask that worry to just be with God. So take this moment. Whatever worries that we hold, Lord God, we give them to you. Because we know that in your hands, anything is possible. As anything is possible, we also pray for Ms. Gomez during this hard time. We pray for her and all those that are in a moment of suffering and in pain. And we pray that doctors, physicians, and caregivers continued and always will be guided by your hand. In Jesus' name, amen. St. Teresa Avila, pray for us. St. Patrick, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Take care, Amrbozic. Now we have morning announcements coming up next.
This is a message from Ms. Tardella. Good morning, Grade 12 Riverhawks. This is a reminder that a very important date, Thursday, January 13, is coming quickly. This is the last day to drop one of your grade 12 courses in Quad 2, and it is the last day to submit your Ontario University applications through OUAC. Please be sure to meet this timeline as it will not be extended in any way.
And now a message from Ms. Tardella. Course selection for the 2022-2023 school year is here. Your teachers have shared in their LMS the information we have provided for you to read over and consider when choosing your courses. On Friday, January 14th at 2:45, the Guidance Department will host a Google Meet for a questions and answer session. Please log in to the Guidance Google Classroom for your grade and join the live session to find out more information and answer any of your questions. Thank you!
Hey CA, a quick announcement. This announcement is from Miss M. Interested in being a student trustee next year? The eligibility requirements are that you must be baptized Catholic and you must be enrolled in a grade 11 or 12 as of September 2022. And you must be able to attend all meetings at the school board level. Please contact Ms. M for more information by joining the Student Council Google Classroom. The code is HSCL2EV. Once again, that's HSCL2EV. Thank you, and please consider attending.
Thank you for your time. Have a great day. And soar on, CA. God bless you all.